Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. And today's video is going to be something that has been in the works for honestly so long, and it's something I'm also very excited about. You can obviously tell from the title that today I'm going to be reacting to one of my subscribers' skincare routine. This video has taken a lot of work in terms of editing, in terms of conceptualizing, in terms of, you know, even contacting you guys. And the subscriber whose routine I'm gonna react to today actually sent her she sent me her video such a long time back, and I even filmed it earlier, and then when I sat to edit it to post it recently, I was like, this is not the way how I wanted it to be, and this is not looking good. So I had to like scrap all the footage, and I had to sit down again and create a new concept and film it all over again. And this video has basically taken a lot of work, which is why I really hope that you guys enjoy it, that you guys, you know, watch the video and, you know, share your feedback with me. Do you want me to do more such videos like these? I feel like now that I have like figured out the trick as to how to make it work, and let me know if you even like the format of the video, the idea and all of that stuff. It would mean so much to me. Obviously, this has been very much inspired by one of my favorite YouTubers, Susan Yara, who does these reaction videos to like celebrity skincare videos on like Harper's Bazaar and Vogue and stuff like that. And I was like, you know what, I have this like I'm always using these new products, testing out new stuff, and I like to share my skincare routines. And those videos are really liked by a lot of you. Like, those videos do so well in terms of views and like watch time, and overall those videos do like really well. So I figured out, you know what, a lot of you don't have such elaborate routines, and I feel like even my subscribers for that matter have much smaller skincare collections, and they follow like the same skincare routine over a period of time. So I wanted your skincare routines to be on my channel so that other subscribers can watch it, and that was what the whole idea was, to do the series. And yeah, that's basically it. I feel like the intro is getting way too long, so now we need my subscriber to introduce herself and to tell you guys about her. So yeah, cue the...
Hi Harshita, I'm so glad to be on your channel. I am Ramani, and I'm going to show you my skincare routine today. I have a combination skin wherein my T-zone is pretty oily and the rest of my face is normal. My skincare routine includes about 5 to 6 steps. I don't do all the steps daily. Some I do weekly or even some monthly. So the steps mainly include cleansing. I always double cleanse whenever I use makeup. And then an exfoliator, a toner, a serum with some active ingredient. I use a mask once in a while and also a moisturizer. So these are some of the steps that I follow. Now I'll show you all of the products that I have in my skincare routine.
So that was what Ramani's skincare routine basically looks like an overview. And I was so happy when she mainly specified on double cleansing. So yeah, now let's move on and like see the products that she uses. And I've like dissected her routine into like different parts. So yeah, let's move on and let's see the products that she uses.
Starting with the cleansers, I use the Herb Day Cleansing Cream. This is in the green tea variant from the Face Shop. I always use a cleansing cream or a cleansing oil whenever I use makeup for the first step of my double cleanse. And then I move on to a foaming cleanser. I use the Himalaya Neem Foaming Face Wash. I love using foaming face washes rather than using the gel ones. So I prefer using this, and this effectively removes the cleansing cream and other residue. The Face Shop cleansing cream does not remove waterproof mascara, so I use the Garnier micellar water to remove any residue that I have.
Okay, so first of all, again, like I mentioned, I was really happy that she double cleanses, and the double cleanse, like the first cleanse that she's using is the Face Shop cleansing cream. Now, she's using a green tea version, and I don't know how many versions they really have. The only version that I have tried and raved about is the Rice Water Bright one, and I feel like the texture of both of them is very similar. And she mentions later on when she's talking about the Garnier micellar water that it doesn't remove like waterproof mascara. Even it doesn't even remove eyeliner, like for example, the Kajal slash eyeliner I'm wearing right now is the Nykaa one, and if I had to remove that with the Face Shop cleansing cream, it would probably either take me a lot of tugging and rubbing, or it would just like still leave some residue. So yeah, I think it's really good that you're using like a bi-phased makeup remover apart from that. And yeah, I'm really happy to see like a makeup cleansing routine. I feel like those two products will do a really good job at removing all of your makeup, like at least majority of it. And the face wash, I feel like the Himalaya Purifying Neem Face Wash is one that I used when I was in school back in the day. I actually used the gel version, and back then I really loved it, and I like sticked to it for like 2-3 years at least. Now I am over it. I have not used it for like over five and a half years. So yeah, you do like cleansing foaming cleansers, and she's using like a different version. Again, like I mentioned, I've tried out the version that she's using, and I didn't find it to be very different from the regular gel version. And I do just want to let you know one thing, that foaming cleansers can be a little bit more harsh and stripping on the skin. And you did mention that you don't like gel cleansers, which I totally understand, but just make sure that your face wash or your cleanser is not too stripping and not too harsh on the skin. It should not like really dry out your skin, so just keep that in mind. And apart from that, honestly, use whatever you want to. So yeah, that was that. I think great routine, great cleansing. I think all these products will do a very good job at actually just like removing all the dirt, grime and makeup. So that's great.
Then coming to exfoliators, I use this Smart Peeling Mild Papaya Gel from the Face Shop. This is a peeling gel. I use this about 2-3 times per week. I use this or the next product that I'm going to show you, which is the Superdrug Naturally Radiant Glycolic Acid Daily Cleansing Pads. These are some cleansing pads which are soaked in glycolic acid. So I use either this or the peeling gel that I showed you earlier about 2-3 times per week. And once or twice in a month, I use this, the ordinary AHA 30% and BHA 2% peeling solution. Let me show you the inside. This is the bottle, and this is truly a magic in a bottle. This is a 10-minute facial. I thoroughly enjoy using.
Okay, so I feel like your exfoliation routine is really great. The Face Shop peeling gel that you mentioned, I haven't used the papaya version, but I have the other version that comes in like a tube packaging, and it's like white and purple. I have a couple of these like peeling gels and stuff, and I feel like a couple of months, maybe even a year ago, I was really into them. Now I just feel like I prefer my AHA BHA serums more than these like peeling gels and stuff. So yeah, I mean, if you love using it, continue using it. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. And the pads that you mentioned, I feel like, again, those are really great. And I actually discovered that Superdrug has come to India after I watched her video. So yeah, some of Superdrug skincare is now on Nykaa, but I feel like instead of using those pads, you can rather buy like a glycolic acid like toner bottle, like maybe the Pixi Glow Tonic or something, and just use your own cotton pads, because I feel like when they make products like these, they are basically just giving you some cotton pads with a glycolic acid toner like solution, and they're basically like jacking up the price. So that is something you might also want to consider. And I just think it'll be overall more economical as well. And last but not the least, the AHA BHA solution by The Ordinary is one that actually she also told me about. And yeah, I think that product is, I mean, it seems really, really amazing. I do want to try it at some point, but obviously The Ordinary is not the most easily available in India. And now that we have Minimalist, I might try the Minimalist version. And at some point I will also try The Ordinary one, because like that product has been like so loved, and it's like it's been like a hyped product for so long that I do definitely want to try that at some point when I can get my hands on The Ordinary products. So yeah,
then I prefer using a toner. This is from a Korean brand. This is a Daisy Nourishing Toner. They also have some leaves floating inside the bottle, which is pretty amazing. It looks really nice and aesthetically pleasing. I use either this one or the Hot Spring Mineral Hydrating Facial Spray from the same Korean brand. This is from Zemi Vogue. This comes in a aerosol packaging, which is really easy to use.
Next, coming to masks, I use the Innisfree Super Volcanic Clay Mousse Mask. This is a heavy duty mask. It pulls out all the dirt and gunk from my pores. And I really love using this. This has a mousse texture. I either use that mask or I use this one. This is a Tony Moly bubble mask. In this, the packaging is really cute. And the bubble mask is also effective and it's really fun to use.
Okay, so she mentioned two toners, and I think that if you're enjoying using them, like the petals in that toner or something, like if you find it cute and like fun to use and all of that stuff, go ahead, continue using it, but it's not something that you need. Like hydrating toners is that extra step which you can easily skip on if you want to save money, if you're on a budget on like a particular month and you have like a money crunch kind of a situation. Toner, like especially hydrating toners, is that one step that you can easily skip. When it comes to masks, the mousse mask, like the one that I tried out, the Innisfree, the tub version, I've already done a video on that. If you want, I'll leave a link in the description box, you can go and check it out. I was not personally so impressed by it, but her views and thoughts were very different, and obviously the version was also different, so I don't know how the two versions differ. But yeah, if you enjoy using it, I mean continue using it, there is absolutely nothing bad about it. And the Toli Moly mask which she actually mentioned is one that even I have owned for, I want to say, maybe close to a year at this point, and I still haven't gotten around to trying it. So after watching her video, now I am inspired to go ahead and pull out mine and to like probably start using it and see. I have literally not used it even once, and it's been sitting in my wardrobe for a year. So yeah, I need to get myself to using that, and I will probably share a review in a future video.
Next, coming to the serums, I use the Ordinary Niacinamide 10% and Zinc 1% serum. I have seen a difference in my skin after using this. I alternatively use this serum or the vitamin C serum from the Ordinary. This is the vitamin C 23% suspension plus HS Fierce 2%. This one is equally good. This is for different purpose. This gives a very radiant skin, and I have been using this for 2 to 3 months now, and I have seen a visible difference in my skin, wherein the acne marks have reduced a lot.
Okay, so I'm really happy to see both of those serums in your routine. Again, we've had a conversation about this, and I feel like I'm pretty sure that Kelly Gooch was the one who got you to like buying all of these Ordinary products, including the AHA, BHA, and even the niacinamide and the vitamin C serum as well. So yeah, if it was Kelly Gooch, then get back to me on that. But yeah, one thing I am a little bit curious about is that you mentioned the exfoliators that you rotate between. And then now you're telling me that you also rotate between these serums. So I'm curious to know that when you're using those exfoliation steps, which serum do you use after that? Like, do you exfoliate first and then use a vitamin C serum after that, like the 23% one? Or do you do the chemical exfoliation with the super drug or the face shop one and then use the niacinamide? Like, I want to know which actives you're pairing together. Like, I'm curious about that, not because I think it's like a sign of danger or anything, but I'm curious to see like which actives are working well together in your personal routine. So I would love for you to like comment down below, because then even other people can see that, or you can just get back to me on DM, because I am really like genuinely curious about that. Because spoiler alert, I'm planning on doing like a video talking about like which actives I use together in a routine and those like work for me or those don't work for me, kind of. So maybe like I could even add your inputs in that video. So yeah, apart from that, I'm really happy to see you using the niacinamide. Again, this is one that even I am personally like wanting to get at some point. The vitamin C, the 23% vitamin C one, I probably will not get, because I watched the Kelly Gooch video and she mentioned that this one, it's like a little difficult to like work with and stuff, and the texture is a little weird and like gritty. And again, I don't even like using vitamin C's at night. I actually like using my vitamin C's in the morning. So yeah, I will probably try like a different vitamin C by the Ordinary, not this one in specific.
And finally, for moisturizer, I use the Pond Super Light Gel. I know this is one of your favorite as well. Also, I really like it. This is a very lightweight gel formulation. I always prefer my moisturizers to be light and in a gel consistency. So I at times use this, or I also use the Face Shop Aloe Vera Gel. This is 99% pure aloe vera gel, and this really soothes my skin. And the last thing, and definitely not the least, is the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunblock. This has 50 plus SPF. I like the texture and the finish that this gives. So this completes my skincare routine.
Okay, so you have no idea how happy I was. Like, the first time she sent me the video, I watched her whole skincare routine, and when I saw the Pond's Gel Moisturizer, I like screamed with excitement. Okay, that is how happy I was. So I'm really, really happy that you love my favorite Holy Grail Gel Moisturizer just as much as I do, if not even more. And I think the Face Shop Aloe Vera Gel is also a pretty good, like moisturizer if you don't want to use the Pond's on a certain day or a certain night or anything of that sort. So I just want to know one thing, which I recently actually found out by watching a couple of other like people do their skincare videos and stuff like that. And because you didn't show me the product texture of the Face Shop gel, the aloe vera gel, I want to know if it's like a clear aloe vera gel, or is it like, does it have like that green color? Because ideally, if you're using these aloe vera gels, they are not supposed to, like, the companies are not supposed to put any of this green color in it, and it is ideally supposed to be clear. So yeah, that's just like a better way. Like, it's better to use a clear aloe vera gel rather than to use a green color aloe vera gel. So yeah, that's just something that, you know, came in my mind because I've been hearing this recently. So yeah, moisturizers are great, and sunscreen, the Neutrogena one, is something that I have also used in the past, maybe like 2-3 maybe even 4 years ago, I don't remember, and I personally did not really like the texture of that one much because it's more of a cream and it can kind of make my face look a little bit greasy. I like to use my gel sunscreens, but you know, at the end of the day, this is something that I think Leah, you say this a lot. Leah, you is the founder of Crave Beauty, and I was binge watching her videos yesterday, and she mentioned that the best sunscreen you can use is the one that you like to use. So if you like to use the sunscreen, then continue using it. It doesn't matter what sunscreen you use. It's just important that you get that SPF protection in your routine. So honestly, use whatever sunscreen you like. Absolutely, it does not matter as long as you include that step. So yeah, that was Ramani's routine, and I think it's a really, really good routine. I don't think that there's anything that she like doesn't do or anything that she needs to correct on any of that sort. I think it's an amazing routine, and yeah, I would love to make this video like a series. I don't think I'll be able to do it every month, but I want you guys to get back to me and let me know if you would want to be a part of this series, if you want me to like react to your skincare routine and share your skincare routine here on my channel. I would love to do that. But yeah, it's obviously not going to become, it's not going to become a thing if, unless and until you guys are interested. And as long as, like, if you guys don't contribute, I obviously cannot let that, like, I cannot do it without you guys, basically. So yeah, please share your feedback with me in the comment section of this video. Get back to me on Instagram. You can DM me, message me anytime, and I will get back to you ASAP. So yeah, I really, really hope that you found this video helpful. In case you're new to my channel, please make sure that you subscribe. Click on the bell next to the subscribe button, because that way you'll get to know every single time I post a new video. I will have my Instagram handle in the description box down below. So if you're not following me on my Instagram, please go ahead and follow me on my Instagram. So yeah, that is pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much to Ramani for being a part of this video, for taking the efforts to shoot and to film and send your video. And again, I apologize for me to like, it took me legit like months to, you know, make this video a thing. So yeah, I apologize from the bottom of my heart for it to like take so long, and for me, like, I made you wait so long. So I'm extremely sorry for that. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Until next time. Bye. Bye.